I've been in this business close to two decades now. So I would say four large shifts. One is certainly from volume to value. I think earlier our whole approach of the companies, of the brands, were to get as much exposure as possible. So things like press releases worked really well. Now most people would think that fewer but bigger, more impactful coverage is much better in the long run because people remember it. And it has a resonance for the brand. So definitely volume to value. One of the things that I like saying is fewer. Few but big. That's one. Second is very obvious. The focus is definitely turning towards digital from print and TV. I'm not saying print and TV are less important. In India, they continue to be important. We are still adding readers, other than, you know, in contrast to various developed countries. And television works as a mass medium. But digital is sharply in focus and is going to be so even more in the years to come. So whoever is working on communication strategies should decide that, you know, keeping that in mind, the shift in mind, and it's only to become bigger. The third, I would think that the lines between global and local have been blurred because apart from hyper-local, which has its own market, any large brand is pretty much now global because people read all over the world, people read from their devices. So nothing really in local news. I'm taking a bad example. If someone dies eating a spurious cola drink in Delhi or a Haryana village, it will take a trice to reach Atlanta or US Press. So if you are, again, a communicator, please keep this in mind, that speed is of essence in responding, because everything is global. Everything has the potential to go global. And fourth is my favorite. I think the whole concept of wine and dine PR has got out the window. Relationships are very critical. They continue to be critical because we're dealing with human beings. But it only depends really whether how much you value you provide to each other. I don't think any of the other things which used to be in vogue 20 years back work anymore on both sides. I would take a step back and say that it depends on, to an extent, on the context. Whether we are talking about a consumer brand where, for instance, market communications, marketing communication, talking to the customer is very important. In an enterprise brand, I worked for an enterprise brand, events or tailored communication, few exposures, significant exposures mattered hugely. And now you also have things like employer brands, where PR can play a very, very critical role along with HR. So, it would definitely depend on the kind of brand that we are also talking about. But communications overall, regardless of what is the brand, has to be strategic and in tandem with business strategy. I mean, communication does not work in isolation, nor does marketing. So to have maximum impact, you have to be in tandem with this business strategy and work as a value provider and an enabler of that business strategy. To hear some good ideas, that's the first thing, you know. You would like to meet peers of the industry to see what they are thinking, how they are approaching problems, what are the solutions. So, I mean, my biggest draw from any large conference is meeting interesting people who are doing different things or doing things differently and having fresh ideas that we can all work on. I really think that our industry, at least in this country, needs to be far more strategic. I often see, I have judged, been jury in other competitions or processes as well. People seem to be really tactical. You see some very good tactical work. I mean, I can see a great press campaign, but a good press campaign will fall flat if the core idea doesn't work or it doesn't support the business, it doesn't deliver the results that you want. So I think communicators around the world, particularly in India, need to be far more strategic in how they approach messaging, how they approach execution, and includes the brand. Many people tell me, younger people who I speak to, that I don't have a seat at the table, how will I influence strategy? My answer is that you have to earn a seat at the table. Please be strategic. Your role is that of a strategic advisor, a counsel, people who people turn to for advice. So unless and until you can deliver that, you will not get that seat at the table. So, I really think that people need to be strategic in their approach, and I'm hoping to see some work which reflects this kind of thinking.